Hey y'all, it's Betsy from Happily Ever After, etc., and I am back with another resin project. So today, I have a really fun project that kind of goes with a few of my other videos lately. I decided that moving into my new house, I'm trying to get projects ready, and one of those things is I'm going to have a little butler's pantry in my new house. I made a little, here's my cat, cat Lily. I made a little pet bowl holder out of a box and a resin top last week. I'll leave a link for that down below. So this week, I thought I would make some matching treat containers. Lily and her brothers and sisters, all my puppies, love treats. And I found these really cute containers at Dillard's on clearance. Excuse me, y'all. And I absolutely love the containers. They are kind of a teal green, which goes really well with the colors of my living room and my kitchen, but the top was wood. So in order to tie that wooden top in to the dog bowl stand that I made last week, I thought we would resin the tops and they would match and it would be fabulous. So let's get started. In order to make these, you're going to need canisters. I bought a canister set that has three different sizes because we have a lot of animals. I like to keep a lot of different treats on hand for training. You can do one canister, you can do matching, you can do differences. That part's up to you, but you need a canister with a lid. Preferably either a wood lid that you can paint and then resin over, or something that's plastic, something that you can pour resin on. That's the main goal, okay? Then you're going to need resin. You're gonna need your safety equipment, so your gloves, you're gonna need a respirator. You need some colors. I use the same 5 I've been using all month. I'm obsessed with them. My blush, rose gold flakes, rose gold glitter, and the white. And it's actually a pretty quick and easy project. Lay down a tray, balance your lids, pour your resin, let them dry, and you're good to go. I actually filmed filling these guys up with some dog treats because we just picked up a couple new bags of Old Mother Hubbard dog treats at Walmart. And so I wanted to see how they fit. They fit great. And my puppies that are going to their new homes in 2 weeks, they had to try some dog treats as well. So I will put all the adorable footage at the end of this video and let's make some dog treat containers. Thank you. All right, y'all. So now our lids are done. They are beautiful. I absolutely love how they turned out. I don't know which one's my favorite. So we are going to finish them. I'm going to put them on our canisters and see how they work. So in order to spray paint the top and everything, I went ahead and took off the elastics. So we're just gonna go ahead and put this back in. I am going to probably paint the bottoms depending on how it looks. But for now, I don't think I need to. So I'm just gonna go ahead and put it back on. Perfectly everywhere, but right here, I did make sure that as these were drying, I went in and kind of cleaned up all the drips on the bottom so that it can fit snug down on top of our canisters. But if you missed any, it's not going to fit perfectly down in that groove. So we're shooting off fireworks in the middle of the day. So if it comes down to it, you can always use a little sander and get that off. That one is perfect. But this is just part of your prep work, taking anything off, painting the top. And like I said at the beginning, the only real reason to paint the top is so that you have a base for your colors to hold on to. So there we go. There is our canister. I kind of love that. So, I think since I have three of them, I'm going to use one for small treats, one for big treats, and one for, I guess, more small treats. I have 8 dogs at the moment, 11, because we have puppies, and we go through a lot of treats training, so I need some really cute dog treat containers. I think these will be perfect. So, let's see. I grabbed a bunch of these mini. They're Old Mother Hubbard brand. These are the peanut flavored. My dogs love these. And then I grabbed just your assortment, which has kind of, you know, the whole kit and caboodle. And then I grabbed the larger, they're still small, they're just not mini, treats in the peanut flavor. And we are going to see how these fit in here. I bet they're gonna be really cute. All right, so let's start. I think we're gonna do small, peanut in the small, assorted in the middle, and large in the large. So, my cat is over here now. Oh, and now even my dog has heard. We smell the treats. She says, can I have that? Honey, you want a treat? You drop it? She came running. We can put the whole bag in there, which is good. Then we won't have to keep the bag. Maybe she's one of my pups that just doesn't love the peanut. Usually they all love the peanut. She's just not my chow hound. You normally like treats though, honey. A little bit of treats in there.
We trapped one.
Do the babies like them? Oh, this one likes them. I just want to smell everything. They're still learning how to eat treats. They are not sure.
They just want milk.
They just want milk.
Where's the other treats you have?
Like a treat? Slim. Slim, you want a treat?
They're too big for my mouth.
You want a small one? Y'all, what do you think? I absolutely love them. I was really worried about the teal with the rose gold and blush tops, but I did a tray that was teal with a similar rose gold color palette last week, and I loved how it turned out, so I figured give it a shot. If you don't like it, you can always resin over it with different colors. So, as you saw, it is puppy tested and approved. How cute are my little babies? And I cannot wait to actually put these in the butler pantry at my new house in 6 to 10 weeks when it is built and ready. And I will show you guys how these look in the final reveal down the road. So if you wanna see my full house reveal, if you wanna see all the projects that I'm working on it, don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell, give it a thumbs up, give a thumbs down if you don't like it, either way. And I'll be back next week with another project. Bye, y'all.